Rochester will go left to right. North Miami right to left. It'll be Hunter and Wood to jump center. Rochester in their road black. North Miami in their home white. Brad Thomas, David Musselman from North Miami. And here we go to the conference showdown of the afternoon. Rochester wins the tip. Riley Holland walks it through the center circle and will set up shop against the 2-3 zone. Works right side to Smith. Now back to Riley Holland. Holland cut off by the defense and throws it out of bounds. North Miami's 2-3 zone creates the first turnover of the game, and North Miami will get it back with 15 seconds gone here in the opening quarter. No score here at North Miami High School. Right side LeFevre stands behind the arc against the man-to-man defense. LeFevre top of the key to Wood. Wood drives left side, cut off at the elbow. Now to West. West a couple of dribbles against Riley Holland, sends right side to Courtney LeFevre just inside the arc. Her jumper on the way is too hard off the back of the iron. Wood with the rebound. Her putback is good. North Miami strikes first. It's 2-0. 7:20 to play in the first quarter.
Shows you how quick Woods is. Pollock tried to get the block out. Woods slipped right off of her and was able to get the rebound.
And strong, absolutely.
Riley Holland stands on the left side against North Miami's 2-3 zone. Dribbles inside the arc. The lob pass over the defense to Hunter. She kicks it back outside to Holland. The lob pass over to Smith. And out of the lane to Murphy. Murph throws a shot up on the glass. It goes, and we're tied at 2.
Carly Murphy doing a good job of splitting the defense there at the top of the key.
West walks it through the center circle. Rochester to man-to-man defense. Works left side out the volleyball line. Now sends to Huffman, top of the key. Now right side to LeFevre. Her long jumper just inside the arc. No good. Murphy with the rebound. Murph will clear and bring it up herself. Now gives to Holland. Walks it through the center circle. Now down low to B. Pollock. B loses it off her hands. Picked up by North Miami. Down to Huffman. And then ball loose. We still have a loose ball. West picks it up. North Miami runs to our left. West. Down the floor, now to Wood, high on the left side for the Lady Warriors. Now to Vincent, the left corner. Vincent around the pick. Dribbles to the free throw line. Now backs now behind the arc. Now gives to Huffman right side to Feet LeFevre. She'll take another 18-footer. No good again. And the rebound to Smith for Rochester. Gives to Holland. Riley runs right through the center circle for Rochester, going to our right. Holland to Smith, high on the right side. One dribble back to Holland on the left wing. Riley studies with 6 minutes to play in the first quarter. Down to Hunter. To Murphy on the baseline. Murph studies, one dribble, high left side to Holland. Now swings right wing to Smith. Haley Smith, one dribble on the wing, gives him the corner, then ball stolen by Josie Wood. Wood left-handed, down the line, down the floor to the left side. Has her ball tipped away, it's in the backcourt, crosses the timeline. Smith dives for it, ball still loose. Here comes Steve Pollock. She picks it up on the right baseline, down low to Holland, and the ball is tipped away and out of bounds by West. Nice help side defense by West, who knocked that out of bounds to keep it alive for North Miami, and wait for the help to get there, and Rochester key possession baseline left. Jeez. Scrum, that's called. Lob pass into Pollock. B, off the window. Yep. Nice entry pass by Holland, and B. Pollock takes advantage of that and puts the Lady Zebras up 4-2. 5:20 to play, first quarter. Wood on the left side, dribbles to the left baseline, cut off by Pollock. Now to Hoffman. Quickly to West on the right wing. West stands behind the arc. Rochester in the man-to-man defense. One dribble gives to LeFevre, top of the key. Foot on the three-point line, jumper on the way is too hard, no good. West with a rebound, and then just ripped away by Holland. Rochester runs to our right after a North Miami turnover. Holland drives the baseline, cut off by the defense. Now gives to Murphy the free throw line. Her jump on the way is good. 6-2 Rochester, 4:50 to play in the first quarter.
Good vision by Holland. Seeing Murphy there at the top of the point.
Nice stroke by Murph to carry that from the free throw line. Ball loose again, picked up over North Miami, now to West, just inside the arc. Her long jumper is no good. And offensive rebound to Josie Wood. Wood to LeFevre on the left baseline, works against Hunter. 4:25 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 6-2. Now to Wood. Josie Wood for three. Left side is in and out, no good. And Ryan Hunter clears the board.
That ball was clear down in against the net. Still pops back out.
Riley Holland out with the board, basketball going to our right to Smith. Here comes Riley Pye for the next opportunity. Lob pass down Luna Pollock. Her jumper on the way is no good. Ball tipped around. Smith comes out of there with it. Bangs it off the hip of Huffman out of bounds. So Rochester will keep possession baseline right. As quickly, North Miami goes to the bench, and they'll bring in Allison C., the 5'4 I'm sorry, the 5'6 junior for North Miami. She'll replace Josie Wood. And Ran Hunter comes out, and Piper is into the game for Rochester. Riley's pass is tipped away right to the hands of B. Pollock. She puts the ball up and good. B, the recipient of the B in the right place at the right time, gets a garbage bucket. Rochester up 8-2. North Miami wants a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Ladies Era Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Thank you.
Farm Toys. We all know someone who collects them, young and old alike. And now until Christmas, New Holland Rochester is taking 15% off all toys. Visit New Holland for the best in-stock selection of genuine New Holland merchandise, toys, and scale model replicas, all at 15% off. From toys to tools, New Holland has the gifts for farming enthusiasts, young and old. Toys and gifts at New Holland Rochester, 7 to 7, Monday through Friday, until 5 on Saturday. New Holland Rochester, Highway 20 South. Your success, our specialty.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
.358 to play in the first quarter. Rochester on an 8-0 run here as they're up 8-2 with .357 to play in the first quarter. And North Miami comes out of the timeout, Brad, and throws it away.
Yeah, Rochester in a full court press, and they cut off the passing lane, and North Miami wasn't able to get a good angle.
We have yet to see Bailey Briggs in the North Miami lineup. Riley Holland with the basketball gives to Murph left wing. Murph just inside the arc, sends right side to Murphy. Murphy down low to Pollock. B has the ball stripped away, but Smith right there to pick it up. One dribble out to Holland. Riley on the right side. Now sets up shot between the rings at the volleyball line against North Miami's 2-3 zone. Bounce pass to Smith on the right side. Gets a pick from Fee Pollock in the paint. He kicks the ball out of bounds. It's going to go back to North Miami. 3:30 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 8-2. Rochester, like Brad said, in a full court press. Vincent looking to get an inbounds, does so to West. Ball tipped away, stolen by Murphy. Murphy in the corner. Used her dribble, now bounce pass top to Holland. Riley runs the play. Smith right side looking for Pollock on the block. Can't get it to her, now to Holland. In the paint to Murphy. Lob pass down low to B. Pollock, and Pollock is going to be fouled on the entry pass. I beg your pardon, she's going to commit a foul on the entry pass. How does that happen? Well, B. Pollock is going to be whistled for the foul. And here come the three freshmen on the floor at once. Keaton Stasiak, Alexa Holland, and Becky Malco. They replace Murphy, Riley Holland, and Smith. Brad Thomas and David Musselman were in North Miami High School. North Miami with the basketball going to our left. C has an inbound being pursued by Stasiak. Man-to-man defense. Bounce pass is stolen by X. X then pushes ahead to Stasiak. Keaton on the right wing. Keaton dribbles to the baseline, cut off by the defense, and then throws the basketball away, picked up by West. North Miami coming the other way, and now X just picks up a, not so smart foul. With 2:56 to play in the first quarter, Rochester up 8-2, and North Miami going to get it back after the Rochester turnover. Vincent looking to get it in on the far sideline, does so to Huffman, gives it back to Vincent on the right side, works against Pollock, feeds down low to Lefevre, outside to Vincent. Vincent in the paint, get past to West. Her 15-footer is no good. Pollock with a good rebound, rips the board, and gives ahead to Malco. Becky runs to our right. Rochester 8-2. Malco loses the handle. Ball still loose on the floor. We're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to go to North Miami on another Rochester turnover.
I kind of thought with the three freshmen coming in, that would give Rochester an opportunity for some perimeter attack. Up to this point with North Miami in the zone, they've been looking at Pollock and Piper and Hunter in the paint.
And speaking of Pollock, she just is replaced by Murphy, and now Keith Stasiak just picked up a blocking foul. 2.5 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 8-2, and it'll be North Miami basketball on the far side. Vincent will look to get it in. Josie Wood will come back in for North Miami. And she'll replace Courtney Lefevre for the Lady Warriors.
It's going to be a mismatch in the favor of North Miami, I think, down low.
Yep. I'm not sure anybody can keep up with Wood. West, being triple teamed, gets it to C. Left side to Wood. Wood against Piper. Takes her to the baseline. Shot no good. The weak side rebound by Huffman. Her shot's no good. The put back by Vincent. She is fouled. She'll go to the line for two. Three opportunities on all that offensive trip for North Miami. Result is a foul in Rochester, and free throw opportunities coming for Lindsay Vincent, the 5'5 senior for the Lady Warriors. Fouls on Malco, her first. Bailey Briggs will make her first appearance into this game right now as Vincent connects on the free throw. So Bailey's in, and coming out is Marissa West. Carissa West, I beg your pardon. So Vincent with one more. It's 8-3 Rochester. Now 8-4 Rochester as Vincent makes both free throws. Alexa Holland brings the ball over the floor for Rochester. Right side of the floor, 2-3 zone by the Lady Warriors. Now to Malco. Back to X. Ball though stolen by Briggs. Back to X. Now to Malco. Malco left side inside the arc. Ball tipped away again. She picks up a dribble. Bounce pass this side to X. X, three on the way, right wing. Nope, in and out, no good. Josie Wood with the rebound, and then Briggs has it. Bailey up the floor, left-handed player. Bailey goes to coast, throws up a prayer, no good. Rebound by Mitchell. Nope, taken away by Vincent. Her putback is no good, and the rebound to Stasiak. Keaton then gives to Malco. Rochester runs to our right, up by four, the minute 45 to play in the first quarter. X left wing, fakes the shot, goes into the lane, throws up a shot, it's no good, but a foul coming on North Miami. That's going to send X to the line for two for the Lady Zebras. Comes against Briggs, her first, team first. A minute 42 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 8-4. And Alexa Holland for the Lady Zebras at the line for two. X ready, right-handed free throw on the way is good. X is a 5'4 freshman. Riley Pfeiffer comes out of the game. Back in is Riley Holland. So basically a five-guard offense right now for the Lady Zebras. Any one of them rip the board and go. X sets herself for the second one. It is in and out and back in off the glass. And Rochester back up by six with a minute 42 to play in the first quarter. Briggs gets the inbounds pass, and she travels. 10-4 Rochester. They'll get the basketball back after the turnover on the far side.
Coach Stasiak trying to pump up the pressure here on the Lady Warriors.
Riley Holland out of the basketball. She'll set up the play between the circles at the volleyball line. Gives the sister X on the left side for the Lady Zebras. X bounce pass to Malco. Looks like Coach Stasiak continues to run some clock, but Bailey Briggs steps in the passing lane, steals the basketball. She goes in for the right-handed layup and misses it. And then, as X clears the board and begins to run, Vincent steps in her way and commits a foul. .120 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 10-4. And Hunter and Murphy back in. Stasiak and Mitchell will sit. You know, it's neat to see. It's nice to see Rob Malco back on the bench. He is helping Coach Stasiak here this year. I know he's not been in a lot of practice early on because of harvest and such, but he is back now in full-time capacity on the bench, and it's nice to have another basketball mind and another basketball set of eyes on the bench. So North Miami commits another foul. I believe it's Vincent again. 1:12 to play. First quarter, Rochester up by six. Vincent comes out back into the game as Lefevre for the Lady Warriors. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Rochester with the basketball, baseline left. X looks to get it in. Does so to Malco. She'll fire a three left baseline off the mark. No good. Josie Wood, the weak side rebound. She runs. Wood up the floor. Loses the basketball out of bounds. It should go to Rochester, and it will. Josie just a little bit out of control there. Probably easily could have been a push-off as she's coming up the floor with no call. Just say, X, top of the key, 2-3 zone for the Lady Warriors. Gives to Riley on the right side, less than a minute to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 10-4. Becky Malco, Riley Holland behind the arc. Holland a couple of dribbles to Hunter at the free throw line to Malco. Quickly down left side to X. X, couple of dribbles to Riley on the right wing. 45 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rochester up by six. Malco runs the baseline. Loses the basketball out of bounds. And actually saves them going out of bounds. Right into the hands of Huffman. Now to Briggs. Bailey brings it up the floor with 30 seconds to play. First quarter. Rochester by six. Towards right side to C. C goes to the basket. Throws up a shot on the defense. No good. But a foul coming on the Lady Zebras. I believe Malco is going to pick up that foul. Regardless, he's going to send C to the line for two.
That was on Rayanne Hunter.
What do I know?
Yeah.
We're a little further away. 25.9 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 10-4. And Allison C at the line to shoot two for her Lady Warriors. UNC's first one on the way is no good. Have you noticed recently that free throws from these kids, both guys and girls, have very little rotation? Have you noticed that?
Not so much, but now that you bring it up, I have seen more flat ball shots.
It's almost like a knuckleball.
Yeah.
And C shoots almost a knuckleball. She misses both free throws, and Murphy for Rochester the rebound. 20 seconds of play, first quarter. Rochester up by six. Riley Holland with the basketball. 2-3 zone by the Lady Warriors. Holland stands in the volleyball line and dribbles at 14 seconds, and her pass gets away and picked up by Huffman for North Miami with eight. Huffman gives the head to Briggs with six. Briggs with five. Works left side to C with three. C behind the arc with two. Briggs throws up a prayer to Bresner. No good. After one, Rochester leading 10-4. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Paint in half the time with new paint and primer in one from Clark and Kensington. Available exclusively at Ace. You'll get top quality, easy to use paint and help that can only come from your neighborhood Ace. People who know their stuff will be right there to help you pick the perfect shade from Clark and Kensington's harmonious color palette. So you can get your weekend back with Clark and Kensington's paint and primer in one. Exclusively at Ace, the helpful place. You can find all of your Ace paints at Smith Farm Stores of Rochester and Plymouth.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. With the winter sports season here, they have all the gear you need. The December holiday specials, 10% off spirit wear, 10% off Under Armour, and 10% off baseball gloves. The Winning Edge offers major apparel brands, Adidas, Duffel and Backpacks, Under Armour and Russell Apparel, and so much more. Visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Ralph Lace Drive, Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Second quarter at North Miami High School, the Lady Warriors trailing the Rochester Lady Zebras 10-4. And Rochester will start, Brad, the second quarter with the basketball. Wasn't real crisp in the first quarter, but Rochester comes out of quarter number one of the lead.
Yeah, they're probably lucky with that. They went through a lot of different lineup changes.
Yes.
They went small, they went big, and they've got a combination of the two in now, and see how that works.
Well, I think the one thing that Rochester likes to do is give the ball to B. Pollock, and this 2-3 zone is creating all sorts of fits for Rochester's offense.
Yeah, they're not really, there isn't really any perimeter threat right now for Rochester, and so, you can pack that zone down, and that's exactly what North Miami's been doing it, cutting away anything for B. Pollock or Carly Murphy down low.
Regardless who is on the block, they're taking it away. Josie Wood's shot is no good, and Smith rips the board. Nice defense by the Lady Zebras, taking Josie Wood's shot away from her. Heck on the right wing. Speaking of outside presence.
Right. I think if you could get Riley Holland or Alexa Holland to knock down a couple of three-pointers, that would really start to stretch that 2-3 out.
Yeah, I
agree. And open things up for Pollock underneath.
Well, if Rochester starts hitting the threes, then you're either going to keep giving them the threes,
right,
or, like you said, bring them out of the zone.
Of course, unfortunately for North Miami, they're in the same situation. They haven't had anything from outside.
Yeah.
And right now, Josie Woods had some good looks in the middle, but she hasn't really capitalized.
Speaking of which, Josie Wood goes to the basket, misses a left-handed layup, ball loose on the floor. X and Lefevre fight for it. It's tied up. It'll stay with North Miami.
Right there is a key example. She makes a great move to get a good avenue down the lane for the layup, but it just won't fall.
That was fairly hard off the backboard.
Yeah.
10-4 Rochester. Briggs has it on the right wing, gives to a cutting Wood in the lane. Outside to Huffman. Now to Wood. Back to Huffman on the right side. Left, right baseline to Briggs. Down low to Lefevre, and we're going to have a foul on Murphy for coming over the back. With 6:47 to play in the first half, Rochester by six, I believe. Nope, they do have a field goal. I thought North Miami's 4 points came on free throws, but they do have a field goal.
Yeah.
Keaton Stasiak back in the game for Rochester, and she'll replace Riley Holland. 6:47 to play in the first half, Rochester up 10-4. As Lefevre looks to get it in for North Miami, baseline right underneath her own basket. Lefevre studies, gets it into Wood. Wood over Stasiak, short. Keaton with the board. Now to X. Rochester runs to our right, up by six. Right side to Stasiak, behind the arc, right side. Now cross court to Murphy. Murphy fakes the three, drives in the paint, cut off by the defense, outside to X. X behind the arc, wide open three on the way is, short. Rebound to B. Pollock, and we're going to have a foul coming on Rochester on the push-off, so North Miami going to get it back with 6:26 to play in the first half.
That foul's going against Kaylee Smith.
That was first.
Yeah.
So Rochester now, their 17th foul already. And North Miami will shoot free throws here the rest of the first half. The Fever at the line, 4-2. First one on the way is good. Very little rotation. She has one more, looking to cut this Rochester lead to 4 with 6:26 to play in the second quarter. Second one is no good off the back of the iron. Offensive rebound to Wood. Josie Wood throws it up. It's no good. And B. Pollock with the board. Pollock now gives the X. Alexa Holland runs quickly to the baseline. Throws up a shot. No good. B. Pollock, the weak side rebound. A putback is no good. Ball being fought for. Huffman comes out of the woods with it. Loses it to North Miami. And we're going to have a traveling on West who grabbed the loose ball and then fell down and traveled.
Wow.
6:08 to play in the first half. Rochester by 5 at 10-5. X with a baseline right for the Lady Zebras. Alexa looks to get it in. Holland studies. Solid. Lobs it into Pollock. Be on the baseline. 8-footer on the way. Rolls off the front of the rim. Murphy's putback is no good. And Smith comes out of the whistle for Rochester. Now to X. X on the wing. Fires up another three. No good again off the back of the iron. And what's the rebound? She runs for North Miami, going to our left. Carissa West has her pocket picked by X. And now Smith picks up the loose basketball. I'm with the North Miami fans here. I don't know how Alexa Holland can roll around on the floor and no travel.
Dive on the ball and then roll over on your back and pass.
I think that's a travel.
Yeah.
Right?
I've seen it called before.
I've seen it called numerous times. You're right. Stasiak, right side. Rochester by 5. X on the left wing. Gives the baseline to Smith. Down low to Pollock. Feet backs the way in. Throws up a shot. It's good. 12-5 Rochester. Their biggest lead of the afternoon is 7. And West breaks a double team. Runs it up to 4. And runs over Pollock. We have a charge on Carissa West. Good job by B. Pollock, who's been in foul trouble a lot this year. Stood her ground, took the charge, and turned over North Miami.
Now she saw her coming down the lane, and she decided she didn't really want a foul, so she's just going to stand and put her hands up and hope for the best. That's how it worked out.
Falco and Pfeiffer back in. Alexa Holland and B. Pollock will sit. Vincent will come back in for North Miami, and Huffman will sit out. 5:06 to play in the first half. Rochester up 12-5. And the Lady Zebras, after the charge, will have the basketball. Malco will run the point now for Rochester against the 2-3 zone of the Lady Warriors. Malco out to Murphy on the left side. Oh, I think she got away with the travel. I don't know. Malco now on the right wing, still behind the arc, dribbling. Cut off by the defense to Murphy. Murphy looking for Smith on the block. Can't get it to her. Bounce pass to Malco. Checky loses the handle, picks up the ball. Now to Murphy between the rings to the volleyball line with 4:35 to play in the first half. Rochester by 7. Malco in the paint. Bailey Briggs rips the ball and travels. Bailey Briggs rolled around on the floor of the basketball.
He's called for a travel.
Murphy, baseline right for the Lady Zebras. Looks to get it in. Does so to Malco over the defense. Malco around the defense. Throws up a shot on the paint. Off the glass. No good. Gets her own rebound. And travels. She actually went over the back of Riley Pfeiffer to get the rebound. And then Riley fell down. And Becky fell on top of
him. Didn't have any place to land.
Full court press by the Lady Zebras. C gives a head to the Fever. The Fever picks up a dribble after 1. Now bounce pass to Vincent. 4:15 to play in the second quarter. Rochester up by 7. C for long 3 is good. First 3 of the game by Eden Squad. And cuts his lead to 4 at 12-8 with 4 minutes to play in the second quarter. Murphy runs the point for the Lady Zebras. 2-3 zone by North Miami. Bounce pass right wing to Malco. Becky, baseline to Stasiak, looking for Pfeiffer on the block. Get past and taken away and stolen by C. Intended for Kaylee Smith on the opposite block where Keaton was. Now to C. C then has it taken away by Smith, and now we're going to have a foul on Kaylee Smith on the reach in. It'll be out of bounds at North Miami with 3:42 to play in the first half.
Foul coming on Carly Murphy, her second. Riley Holland back in, and Pete Pollock back in. Murphy and Riley Pfeiffer will sit. 3:42 to play in the second quarter. Rochester up 12-8. Now let's see the line to shoot one of the bonus for her Lady Warriors. Sees first one on the way is good. We'll have one more. Looking to cut this lead to two with this freebie. Well, Rochester's had probably 2-1 opportunity offensively. Hadn't been able to make a connect. They ran more plays for sure than
right.
Miami.
Yeah, you're right.
Second free throw, no good by Steve. So it's a 3-point lead in favor of Rochester. 12-9 right now for Lady Zebras. Pollock in the paint, foul on the shot, so go to the line to shoot two.
I think you got to give credit to North Miami's 2-3 zone. It's been really effective here in the first half.
Josie Wood picks up a foul. That'll send P. Pollock to the line for two for Rochester. Pollock, a 5'10 junior for the Lady Zebras. First one on the way for B is no good off the back of the iron, so I have one more. 12-9 Rochester, 3:27 to play. In the second quarter coming up a break, we'll talk to Rochester junior varsity coach Randy Wynn. The Lady Zebras junior varsity wise suffered their first loss of the year. 30-29 at the hands of North Miami. Second one by Pollock just barely draws iron. Ball tipped around, and Smith has it. And now we're going to have an out-of-bounds call on Kaylee, I believe.
Yeah.
Stepped on the basketball and stepped on the end line at the same time. So B. Pollock thought probably a little bit too much about that free throw and just barely drew anything. Josie Wood brings it up before against Stasiak. Pushes off, no call. Switches directions. Crossover dribble works left side, now to Briggs. Briggs against Malco, drags her to the baseline. Cut off by the defense, now to C. C against Pollock, step back three on the way is no good. And the rebound is fifth. 12-9 Rochester, 3 minutes of play in the first half, and Rochester runs to our right. Riley Holland. Outside to Malco, between the circles of the volleyball line. Now works left side. 2-3 zone by the Lady Warriors. To Riley Holland, high on the right side. Holland dribbles inside the arc to Malco and makes that to Stasiak. Team picks up her dribble. Bounce pass top of the key to Riley Holland. And she is going to be fouled on the shot. Yep. She'll go to the line to shoot two. As I believe, C just picked up a foul.
Yep, she did. And they're going to say it was on the shot, so Holland will be shooting two.
2:43 to play in the first half. Rochester up by three, and Riley Holland, one of the two seniors for Rochester at the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. First on the way is good. Dunham Bennett caught one more.
A lot of rotation on that one.
There was?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. See, that's why I bring you along, Brad. Alex Holland back into the game. Keaton Stasiak will sit. Riley with one more. Looking to push this lead back to five. Second one on the way is in and out and back in. And West back in for North Miami, and Briggs will sit. 14-9 Rochester, 2:43 to play in the first half. C looks to get it in against pressure. Does so to West. West against the double team. Cut off by Pollock and Malcolm. Make that Holland. Gives it to C. C now directs traffic. She brings it up the floor. Feeds down low to Huffman. Gets away with the travel, but Holland rips the ball away. Riley runs to our right. Up by four. Riley outside to X. X thought about a three. Passes it up. Now to Malco high on the right side. 2:20 to play in the first half. Bounce pass to Riley Holland. Bounce pass to X. Alexa back to Riley. Back to Alexa left side. Feeds down low to Smith. Smith to Riley Holland in the paint. Around the defense. Throws up a shot off the glass. It's no good. Gets her own rebound. The putback is no good, but a foul coming on Huffman. And Riley Holland will go to the line to shoot two. 2:05 to play in the first half. Rochester up 14-9. And Riley Holland at the line to shoot two shots for her Lady Zebras. Huffman with a foul, her first. Now both teams will shoot free throws from here on out. Riley makes the first free throw. They're making a 6-point lead again at 15-9. Riley's second one, no good again, no good this time, and Huffman with the rebound.
gives to West. North Miami runs hard to our left. West hesitates, accelerates, goes to the baseline. Outside out of Huffman. She runs over Malco on the shot, and we're going to have a foul on the shot. It'll be two shots for Huffman as Becky Malco is going to pick up a personal. Be her second. Keaton Stasiak will come in after the first free throw by Tiffany Huffman. Left-handed shot on the way is good. Stasiak back in. Malco will set with two personals. Rand Hunter will come back into the game, and she'll replace Smith. .154 to play in the first half. Huffman with one more free throw for North Miami, and she misses it. Nice block out by Hunter. Gives away for Stasiak to grab the rebound and gives it to X. Rochester by five. X on the right wing. Lob pass to Murph. Make that to Pollock. To Hunter. Her shot's no good, but she is going to be fouled on the shot, and Rand Hunter will go to the line to shoot two. How about that communication and ball movement by the post players?
Yeah, it was a good job by Pollock to recognize that she drew the triple team.
Yeah.
And that Hunter would be open on the opposite block as she wrapped around, passed across the lane to her.
Allison Hunter picked up foul number two for the Lady Warriors. As Rand Hunter, first free throw is off the back of the iron, no good. 1:45 to play in the first half. Rochester up 15-10. And Hunter with one more from the charity stripe. Second one is good this time. A low line drive shot goes. And Rochester back up by six, and now we'll jump into a 4-4 press. West against Stasiak. Man-to-man press. West works right side. Now push off. Not good call. We'll push off by West. And North Miami has done that virtually a lot of the afternoon.
A couple of times.
Yeah. And that time was called for. That's pretty blatant. That was right in front of the official and where nobody else could shield her from that foul. 16-10. Rochester with 90 seconds to play in the first half. Riley Holland on the right wing. Gives it to X top of the key. Alexa Holland around the defense. Back outside to Holland. Riley Holland on the right side. Bounce pass to Keith Stasiak. And her pass is kicked away by C. And Rochester will keep possession with a minute 19 to play in the second quarter, up by six.
See just a little bit of hesitation in Alexis Holland's eyes when she gets that ball out.
She's open
for three. Wants to shoot,
yeah,
but she hasn't made one yet, so she's a little hesitant.
Riley over the defense to Alexa. Back to Riley, right side. She'll fire a three from the corner. No good. And the weak side rebound to Wood. And the loose ball. Wood loses it as she goes to four. Loose ball is tied up between X and the C. And Rochester going to keep possession baseline right. Briggs back into the game. The C to sit. Riley Holland looks to lob it in. Does so to Hunter in the paint. Kicks it out to Alexa, make that Riley Holland on the right wing. A minute five to play in the first half. Rochester by six. Keith Stasiak pass knocked away and stolen by North Miami. Now West comes to our left. West against Stasiak. Down low to Huffman, and Huffman's going to be fouled by Hunter on the entry pass. And it's going to send Huffman to the line to shoot free throws for the Lady Warriors with less than a minute to play in the first half. Rochester by six. Tiffany Huffman, the 5'8 senior, at the line to shoot two for the Lady Warriors. First one on the way is no good. So I have one more. Riley Pfeiffer back into the game. Hunter with two personals will sit. And Huffman with one more. Second one is short. Pollock with a rebound. Gives to Riley Holland. 50 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester by six. And Coach Stasiak, Brad, I'm sure, would like to shoot for the final shot of the half.
Absolutely. Zebras are just one field goal in that second quarter.
Good. Yeah. They've taken two or three three-point shots. Now Alexa Holland will stand in the circle and dribble. And listening to instructions given by Coach Tony Stasiak, North Miami stays in that 2-3 zone. 25 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester by six. 16-10. X still at the volleyball line and dribbles with 15 seconds. Alexa Holland holds and dribbles with 12 seconds. Now with 10, and now Lady Zebras will start the offense. Riley Holland high on the left side with 7. Holland with 6. To X with 4. Alexa Holland over Josie Wood for 3. With 3 is good.
and a half time. Rochester extends their lead to 9 at 19-10.
Choose Easy Care Interior Paint for one coat coverage. See Enyer's line of Melissa and Doug toys. They have the largest selection in the area, and these beautiful toys are child safe and child friendly. For holiday gift giving, check out Enyer's line of housewares. They've added to their selections to make your shopping easier. And from lighted trees to a full line of holiday decor, including wrapping paper, light sets, garlands, serge strips, gifts, bags, and tags, well, Enyer's has you covered. Enyer's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
Back at North Miami High School for the third quarter. The Lady Zebras make the Lady Warriors start with the basketball here in the second half. Trailing 19-10, and about as quick as this half starts, B. Pollock just picked up foul number two, and it's going to send Carissa West to the line to shoot two for the Lady Warriors. First on the way is good. That one had a lot of rotation.
Yeah, it did.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Don't forget, tonight is a doubleheader here on WROI. The guys back in action as they host the Lewis Cass Kings tonight at Rochester High School, so you'll be listening for that. Tony Ziziak will join us tonight. Second one is good as it rolls around and falls through.
So it'll be a much better broadcast.
Actually, you know what would be the best? Is if you and Tony did it.
If Tony and I did it, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Both free throws made by North Miami, and on the first possession of the half for Rochester, they turn it over into the hands of C, and then it's thrown out of bounds. They're going to say tipped out of bounds by Hunter. It'll stay with North Miami baseline right. 7.5 to play, third quarter, Rochester by 7. Vincent looks to get it in, lobs it over the defense, taken away by Pollock.
Looks like a lob to Pollock.
Last time there was a lob to Pollock like that on offense, she was the one that picked up the foul. I don't understand that. Still not sure how I understand that. Riley Holland to Smith, loses it out of bounds. Rochester going to give it away again. Seven-19 to play in the third quarter. And Rochester up by 7 at 19-12. Keely Smith comes out of the game, and Alexa Holland back in for Rochester. West works against the man-to-man defense, and Riley Holland. West picks up her dribble. Down low to C. C fakes. One dribble around Hunter. Down low to Wood. Josie Wood puts up a shot. No good. That thing, too, Brad. Yeah. Down and came back.
She still can't get the ball to fall through. She's had a lot of open looks down low.
So Riley Holland runs the point right wing, gives it X on the left side. X a couple of dribbles on the wing. 2-3 zone by the Lady Warriors. Outside to Riley. Feeds down low to wide open Hunter. Her left hand layup is good. Rochester back up by 9 at 21-12. What's that? Rope always looking to get a little air time.
Yeah.
C's jumper for make that Lefebvre's jumper from the baseline is no good. B. Pollock, a nice lockout and rebound, gives Riley.
I feel bad for you. She's just like always picking on it. I don't get it.
X the free throw line out to Riley Holland. God, I might have started that one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Riley left wing just inside the arc, picks up her dribble, now gives top to Alexa Holland. Bounce pass right side to Murphy. Murph to Alexa, top of the key. 2-3 zone by the Lady Warriors. Under 6 to play in the third. Rochester up by 9. Baseball pass left side to Murphy. 3 on the way. Left wing is no good. Short. And the rebound to Huffman, who clears to West. Gives ahead to Wood. Josie Wood at the free throw line. Out to West. Should take the fall away jumper. No good. Pollock with the rebound. Another good block out and rebound by B. Pollock. Riley runs the other way. Riley right through the center circle for Rochester. Low look pass to Alexa. In the paint to Huffman. Lob pass down low to Pollock. B, jumper. Nope. And a foul coming for over the back on Lefebvre as Pollock again had good position to grab that offensive board, but Courtney Lefebvre came over her back and committed a foul. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester baseline right. 5:26 to play in the third. Bailey Briggs comes back into the game and Josie Wood to sit. 21-12 Rochester. Riley Holland looks to trigger it in. Riley bounce pass to Alexa Holland. Almost stolen, and now is stolen by Bailey Briggs, who gives the head to see. Midfield Lefebvre. Lefebvre, left side of the floor. Shot over Hunter, no good. Rayan then clears the board, and then is fouled by North Miami on the reach-in. And it'll be North or Rochester basketball going to our left with 5:15 to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 9. Riley walks it up. Actually, Alexa walks it up for Rochester. Right through the center circle, right through the Warrior head. Goes in the lane, cut off by the defense to Riley outside. Riley bounce pass to Alexa Holland, fakes the three, now dribbles, stands still behind the arc. Now in the paint, loses the handle, kicks it out to B. Pollock, who bounce passes top to Riley Holland, left side to Murphy. Murph. To Alexa Holland. I'll tell you what, X did a great job by shielding the basketball. As Courtney LeFever coming on hard to steal that. LeFever then runs over Alexa Holland and picks up her third personal foul.
Alexa doesn't play second base, does she, by chance?
Shortstop. You know what? I'm not sure, but I got a feeling that she could probably play wherever she wanted.
Yeah. Almost looked like she's trying to protect the bag there.
Yeah. I know she played a lot of infield when she and Kennedy played together, which is a good time. Riley Holland with the basketball goes to Alexa on the right wing. Rochester by 9 with 4.5 to play in the third quarter. Bounce pass to Murphy. That pass to handle goes out of bounds. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. North Miami High School. Both teams looking for their first conference win of the season. Right now, Rochester up by 9 with 4.5 to play in the third. Carissa West, bounce pass left side to Vincent. Vincent takes a shot, drives in the paint, goes around the defense, and gets down low to Huffman, and then Huffman was fouled down low. And it'll be out of bounds for North Miami with 4:19 to play in the third.
That foul comes on Riley Holland. That'll be her first.
Stasiak back in the game. Murphy to sit. Vincent looks to get it in over Hunter. Baseline left. Vincent has her pass tipped, but right into the hands of C. She fires a long three. It's no good. And the rebound to Briggs. And Bailey's going to be fouled before the shot on by Rochester.
That's going to be on Rayanne Hunter, her third.
How in the world does Bailey Briggs, who stands at a generous 5'4", get a rebound over Rayanne Hunter, who stands 6 foot?
Yeah.
How? That's not a rhetorical question.
No,
that happened.
It just, yeah.
Vincent looks to get it in over the defense to C. Another long three for C is no good. And the ball is tipped out of bounds on the rebound by Pollock. North Miami going to try it again. What was the score at the halftime?
19-10.
Okay.
Yeah. So
Briggs throws up a quick shot. No good. Keeps Stasiak with the rebound, and we're going to foul the reach-in by North Miami. I believe it's going to be on Briggs.
By Briggs, yeah.
Both teams are going to be shooting free throws before we get to the three-minute mark.
Well, I think it'd be fair to say that both teams struggled mentally today.
30-second timeout taken by Rochester. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. With the winter sports season here, they have all the gear you need. The December holiday specials, 10% off spirit wear, 10% off Under Armour, and 10% off baseball gloves. The Winning Edge offers major apparel brands, Adidas, Duffel and Backpacks, Under Armour and Russell Apparel, and so much more. Visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Ryle Place Drive, Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:08 to play in the third. Rochester up 21-12. And after the Lady Zebra 30-second timeout, they'll have the basketball going to our left. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Alexa Holland runs it right through the center circle for the Lady Zebras against the 2-3 zone. Left wing pass to Stasiak. Now in the paint to Holland. Riley has her shot partially blocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left. Oh, Jesus. Everybody from North Miami is complaining because Riley Holland threw that out of bounds. Seriously?
Yeah.
Nobody shoots the basketball like that.
It was straight out. I mean, there was no arch to it at all.
Please.
It was great.
First day watching basketball for crying out loud. Riley Holland with the ball. Lobs it in over the defense to Holland to Riley. Down low to Piper. Riley Piper backs the way in. Has her shot partially blocked right into the hands of Piper. She puts up, makes that two. Pollock, she puts it up for two. V's approaches 10, yes. She has eight.
Eight.
Smith around the defense, foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two, make that Josie Wood on the drive, and she'll go to the line to shoot two for North Miami, who now trail 23-12.
Holland will pick up her second.
Josie Wood, who just verbally committed to IU a few days ago, has her first free throw rattle home.
That's pretty good for a sophomore.
Yeah, you ever seen her?
Yeah.
I think she probably could have committed to IU as an eighth grader. Second one, no good by Wood. Pollock with a rebound. She's really good.
Yeah.
With a lot of speed. So Rochester has it going to our left. A 3.5 to play in the third quarter, up by 10 at 23-13. Daziak at the free throw line. Get off on the 2-3 and travel.
All right.
Rochester now will step up in a man-to-man press. Nope, beg your pardon, they won't. Briggs will bring it up quickly. Briggs will work against Holland. This is a nice match. Actually, Brad, this is the kind of matchup I was looking for all afternoon.
Briggs
to Holland.
Yeah.
Yeah. And unfortunately, it never developed until right then. Josie Wood is...
Oh!
And she pushed off again and got away with it again.
I think the one out, the official out here on the front court wanted to call that, but she didn't blow her whistle.
You're right. She let the guy underneath take the call. And Keaton's going to be whistled for a foul with 3:11 to play in the third. Vincent lobs it into Josie. Wood shot. Good off their window. 23-15. Boy, if she gets a little look out. 23-15, Rochester under three to play in the third. North Miami has not come out of a 2-3 zone all afternoon.
No, as they should. They've been doing pretty good with that zone.
High from the paint, foul on the shot, no call. Ball tipped around, Brace has it. And travels. Boy, Riley Holland in a tough position there. It looks like she got her leg rolled up. She had somebody roll up on her leg, and she doesn't show signs of limping, so she must be all right. So it'll be Rochester basketball out of bounds after the turnover. Riley looking, lobs it into Piper. Piper then gets it to Stasiak at the free throw line. Keaton down low to Pollock. Ball tipped away and stolen by Josie Wood. Now stolen back by Keaton Stasiak. Now we're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to stay with Rochester.
Give it a foul on 12, coach.
2:37 to play in the third. It'll be Rochester basketball to bounds, 23-15, Lady Zebras.
Down low to Pollock, and she's not able to turn around with it. She's fouled.
Good heavens. You know what we should have done?
What's that?
When this quarter should have started, we should have put down what time it was. .34 to play in the third. Rochester up 23-15. Riley Holland gets it in over the defense. Actually stolen now by Bailey Briggs.
Yep.
Briggs throws up a shot. No good. Too hard. Seeing the footbacker. Shot no good. And a foul coming on Rochester. And Allison Seen will go to the line to shoot two.
Be Alexa Holland second. Good job, Briggs, just poking that ball up in the air and then chasing it down.
Really tough to outthrow Bailey Briggs. Even though she's standing 5'3 or 5'4, her speed makes up for a lot of her.
Oh, yeah.
Seed's free throw is good. 23-16. Rochester up. Malco back into the game. Riley Holland to sit. Murphy will come back in for Rochester. And Murph will replace Riley Piper. One more free throw coming for C. Looking to cut this lead to six. Second one rattles in. It's good. 23-17. Rochester up. 2:25 to play in the third. Malco runs the point for the Lady Zebras. North Miami in that 2-3 zone. Bounce pass right wing to Murphy. Murphy face against Briggs. Speeds down low to Pollock. Pollock on the baseline. Cut off on the double team and throws it away. That was a great entry pass by Murphy.
Yeah.
But Pollock called it too deep.
She went the wrong direction. Got behind the backboard.
Wood, one dribble. Top to Vincent. Left side to Huffman. 2 minutes to play in the third. To Josie Wood. Back to Vincent. Vincent to paint. Oh. And Pollock is going to pick up a foul.
Wow. Another episode that could have gone the offensive way. Pollock will pick up her third. Both she and Rayanne Hunter with three.
So Smith back into the game for Rochester, and Pollock will come out. With 1:56 to play in the third, Rochester by six at 23-17. And Tiffany Huffman at the line to shoot one of the bonus. First one's good, and she'll have one more. One more coming for the senior, Tiffany Huffman. She's ready. Fires a left-handed free throw. Good again as the final 10. 23-19, all of a sudden, his 12-point lead at one time is now down to four. Becky Malko runs the point for the Lady Zebras. Bounce pass to X. Alexa Holland, the only Holland on the floor right now for Rochester, gives to Murphy. Murph dribbles top of the key, inside the arc, takes it outside to Stasiak, behind the arc on the left right side. Bounce pass to X. Alexa Holland regains the dribble, works left wing, crossover dribble back to the right side. Gets high on the right side to Stasiak with a minute 30 to play in the third quarter. Outside to X. X step back three on the way for the Lady Zebras. It's short, and the rebound to Stasiak, and before that, Kaylee Smith is going to climb the back of, I believe, C.
That'll be her second.
And so make that climb the back of Vincent, and Vincent will walk again into the floor, shoot one of the bonus with a minute 22 to play in the third quarter. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Vincent's free throw is good, and all of a sudden, North Miami red hot on the charity stripe. Vincent with an opportunity to cut this lead to two.
8-9 of it in this quarter.
Second one by Vincent is good again. North Miami on a 10-0 run right now. And it's 23-21 of a minute 15 to play in the third quarter. Murphy takes the basketball to the block. Outside to Alexa Holland, left wing. Now the free throw line of the paint. She loses the handle, but a foul coming on. Looks like Bailey Briggs. It will be out of bounds to Rochester, baseline right.
That'll be her third.
23-21 Rochester. West will come back into the game, and Bailey Briggs will sit down. Well, Pollock picked up a tic-tacky foul, and so did Bailey Briggs. Alexa Holland looks to get it in, baseline right. Bounce pass to Falco. Falco, Stasiak inside the arc, left side. 60 seconds to play in the third.
3 seconds.
Holland, Stasiak to Murphy. Rochester by two as the third quarter ticks away here at North Miami High School. Alexa Holland in the corner to Malco. Becky saves from going out of bounds. Tip throws through the defense, loses the handle. Can be tied up between G and C. And North Miami going to get it back with 44.7 to play in the third quarter. Rochester just up by two. Full court press by the Lady Zebras. West in the backcourt. West against Malco. Gives to C with 42. C has it with 33. To Huffman, down low to Woods. Turnaround jumper is no good, but a foul coming on Rochester, and Josie Wood will go to the line with an opportunity to tie this game at 23 with 31 seconds to play in the third.
That foul's on Malco, her third.
That's probably a good thing that Rochester had more people on the bench today.
Right.
Josie Wood's free throw is good. She'll have one more. 23-22 Rochester, and Josie Wood with an opportunity to tie this game up with 31 seconds to play in the third. Left-handed free throw is good again. 23-23, North Miami on a 12-0 run with 25 seconds to play in the third. Alexa Holland dribbles it, standing in the center circle with 15 seconds. X dribbles now at the volleyball line with 12. Rochester make that North Miami to 2-3 zone. X now runs with 8. Works left side to Murphy with 7. Murph a couple of dribbles with 5. Out to Becky Malco with 3. To Alexa Holland, set back 3 at the volleyball line at the buzzer. No good.
after three quarters. We're tied at 23. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Paint in half the time with new paint and primer in one from Clark and Kensington. Available exclusively at Ace. You'll get top quality, easy-to-use paint and help that can only come from your neighborhood Ace. People who know their stuff will be right there to help you pick the perfect shade from Clark and Kensington's harmonious color palette, so you can get your weekend back with Clark and Kensington's paint and primer in one. Exclusively at Ace, the helpful place. You can find all of your Ace paints at Smith Farm Stores of Rochester and Plymouth.
What would you do if they put you in power? Would you make toll roads free or use the express line when you have more than 15 items? How about lowering your gas prices? The BP Visa with Pump Rewards does just that. Use it virtually everywhere, and you can save when you fill up. Apply today at BP.
Account subject to credit approval. Restrictions and limitations apply. BP Visa credit cards are issued by Chase Bank USA NA. See application located inside the station for pricing and rewards details. Purchases made at merchants where non-BP gasoline is sold do not earn rewards.
Back at North Miami High School for the fourth and final quarter. We're going there tied at 23. North Miami on a 12-0 run, Brad, to end the third quarter.
Yeah, and, you know, Coach Stasiak always likes to win that free throw battle. And right now they're getting killed at the free throw line. Well, North Miami, 11 of 12 in that third quarter alone from the line.
So Rochester starts the fourth and final quarter of the basketball. We're tied at 23. Riley Holland back into the game. Works to the left wing. Looks the baseline to X. Now has her on the wing. Down low to Hunter. Rand backs away in. Throws a baby hook out on the shot. Shows it wide for two. Seal 7:48 to play in the game.
Seal pick up her third.
Rand Hunter is the one of two seniors for Rochester at the line to shoot two. Rand ready. Steps up, sets herself, fires the first one, and it's good as it bangs home. Rochester back up 24-23. That stops that 12-0 run. Rand's second one. Good again. 26, make that 25-23. Full court press by Rochester. West gets it to Vincent. Now out to C. Quickly to Wood. Wood against Murphy. One pass to C for a long three. Short. And Rand Hunter grabs the board. And now to Holland. Rochester by two with 7:30 to play in the game. Riley Holland, as she brings it up the floor. Near side to Murphy. Murph looks from the baseline to X. Hazard. So it's a bounce pass. Back to Murphy. Quickly right side to Riley Holland. Back to Murphy, left side. Shot fake. Down. Gives to X, who's running the baseline. Now feeds down low to Hunter. Hunter shot partially blocked. Ball loose. And Pollock comes out of there with it. The Holland, her jumper's good. How does that happen?
And Pollock with a great steal is able to get it to Holland for the short jumper.
And we're going to have a traveling, should, or a carry on North Miami, and the Warriors are going to give it back to the Zebras. And North Miami will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
When it comes to buying a home, you can draw on the experience of the mortgage lenders at First Federal Savings Bank. Since 1966, First Federal has provided financing to homeowners throughout the area. First Federal is locally owned, so loan approvals are made here and loan servicing is done in your hometown. Free pre-qualifications are available at First Federal Savings Bank, 301 East 9th in Rochester and 814 North US 35 in Winnemac. Offices are also in Plymouth, Bremen, Elkhart, and Mishawaka. First Federal is FDIC insured and an equal housing lender. Borrowers must meet underwriting guidelines and a delivery fee may be applied to the loan. NMLS 399927.
Don't miss the opportunity to share the fantastic programming available this holiday season exclusively on RFD-TV, culminating with the broadcast of the 2013 Tournament of Roses Parade. This free preview is an opportunity to allow all expanded basic Rochester Telephone Company cable customers to sample the 100% family-friendly programming on RFD-TV. Beginning December 17th through January 2nd, you will find RFD-TV on on RTC Channel 80. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from all of us at Rochester Telephone. And give us a like on Facebook. We'd love to have you as our friend.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at North Miami High School, after the timeout, Rochester quickly got the ball inbounds to Hunter, who had her shot blocked and taken away by North Miami. So Vincent has it now on the right wing for the Lady Warriors. Rochester up by 4 with 6.5 to play in the game. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. C for 3. Nope. Cozy Wood to the weak side rebound. Wood works left side. The C, or makes that to West. Bad pass was out of bounds. It'll go back to the Lady Zebras up by 4. Again, both teams, Brad, looking for the first conference win of the season.
Both teams starting to scrap a little bit here in the fourth quarter as they realize, you know, time's ticking away.
Right.
They don't want to be the one that goes to 0-3.
Riley Holland to Murphy, left side. Murph baseline to Alexa Holland. Cross-court pass to Riley, around the defense. Get pass into Alexa, down low to Hunter. And Rand Hunter's fouled on the shot, through the line for two. Tiffany Huffman going to pick up the foul.
That'll be her second.
Because the JV contest today went to North Miami Rochester. The Lady Zebras JV-wise suffers her first loss of the year. The final of 30-29, Lexi Holland had 9 for the Lady Zebras. Hunter has 2. First one, good. But one more. Courtney Lefevre coming back in for North Miami and Zeta Smith. .604 to play in the game. Rochester up 27-23.
Watch out!
I make that 28-23. Second by Hunter is good again. Rand Hunter, 4-4, the last two trips to the line for the Lady Zebras. Full court press by Rochester. Josie Wood gets an inbounds and brings it up the floor. Wood, outside left to Huffman. Huffman back to Wood on the baseline. Makes a shot. Loses a dribble, I believe. Now to Vincent. To a cutting. Fever in the lane. She puts up a shot for 5 feet to go. The lead is cut to 4 at 29-25 with 5:40 to play in the game. Riley Holland takes her time bringing it up the floor. Now to Murphy on the left wing. Murph cross court to Riley Holland. Down low to Pollock. V against the double team. Throws up a shot. No good. And Lefevre with the board. Now to Vincent. Vincent runs for North Miami. Vincent goes coast to coast, left hand to layup. No good, too hard. Ball tipped out of bounds by Hunter. It'll stay with North Miami. 5:17 to play in the game. Rochester up by 4, 29-25. Vincent, baseline left for North Miami, looks to get it in. Vincent studies. And the ball tipped out of bounds by Holland. It'll stay with North Miami, baseline right.
Both Pollock and Hunter for Rochester with 3 fouls.
I'll tell you what, Pollock with 3 fouls is in your face defense.
Yeah,
right now.
I'll say that has stymied the intensity of their defense, isn't it?
Ball loose. They're going to have a tie up, and North Miami will keep possession. North Miami basketball, baseline right. Vincent looks to get it in with 5:12 to play in the game. Rochester by 4. Vincent over the defense to Huffman. Huffman in the plane against Hunter. Outside to West for a long 3. Nope. And Alexa Holland with the rebound. X runs for Rochester. Right side of the floor. Going to our left. X behind her left, between her legs dribble out to Murphy, top of the key. Murph left side to Riley. Holland left wing. Back to Murphy right side. Now middle of the floor. Murphy, one dribble in the baseline to Alexa Holland. Down low to B. Pollock. She's found the shot. No call. She puts the shot up. It's good.
Nice job by B. Pollock. She's strong on that shot.
Yeah. Strong indeed. She was packed. 31-25 Rochester, 4:35 to play in the game. And now we're going to have a 5-second call. Nice defense by Alexa Holland, who was in the jersey of West.
Yeah, it was good defense. You don't see those 5-second penalties very often. That was a great job of taking away any passing options that she was looking for.
Keely Smith back into the game. She replaces Rayan Hunter for the Rochester Lady Zebras, who lead by 6 with 4.5 to play in the basketball game. Murphy against the 2-3 zone. Skip pass to Riley. High on the right wing. High on the right side. Holland back to Murphy, left side. Murphy studies. Goes overhead. Gives in the corner to Alexa Holland for three in the right baseline. No good. Offensive rebound to Murphy. Her putback is good.
Nice job by Carly Murphy. She makes the pass cross court from out front and then busts her butt to get on.
And now Pollock steals the basketball, but can't favor going out of bounds. Sorry, Brad.
Murphy made a great job going from outside the lane or outside the three-point arc down on the block to get that rebound on the missed shot on the weak side.
North Miami wants a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance Agency of Rochester, they know anything can happen at any given time without notice. They also know that finding the right insurance for the right price is really pretty easy. That's why they are your local trusted choice agent, which means they have access to multiple insurance companies that offer competitive pricing and coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street. You can also visit them online at SmithSawyerINS.com. Since 1932, Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance has protected individuals and families from those unforeseeable events in life.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:06 to play in the game. Rochester up 33-25, and as Bailey Briggs brings it up the floor, she is stripped from behind by Kaylee Smith and out of bounds. It'll stay with North Miami in front of their own bench, going to our right. Vincent gets it into Bailey Briggs. Briggs is called.
We're going to have a blocking foul on Pollock.
Bailey runs over Breanne and got the fortunate call, and Bailey Briggs will go to the line to shoot two shots for her Lady Warriors, who now trail by eight with 4 minutes to play in the game. Briggs at the line for two.
I think at this point you just leave Pollock in and take your chances.
Yep. Right until she fouls out, you're right.
Yep.
First free throw is no good by Briggs. She'll have one more. 33-25 Rochester with 3:59 to play in the basketball game. Bailey's second one good this time. 33-26 full court press, man-to-man press by North Miami. Murphy to Riley Holland. Holland ahead to B. Pollock. Pollock now out to Murph. Up by seven, 2 minutes to play in the game. And now North Miami extends that 2-3 zone to the volleyball line. Alexa Holland high on the right side. Now we got a man-to-man defense. Alexa Holland dribbles to the near side. North Miami is a mass confusion going to that man-to-man. They don't do it much. Riley Holland cut off by the defense. Fly pass down low to B. Pollock. Her layup is good.
Great pass and great bucket by Pollock.
And that's what happens when you go man-to-man.
Yeah.
Vincent around the defense has her pocket picked, but the ball goes out of bounds. Quick hands by Riley Holland, who picked the pocket of Vincent. It goes out of bounds with 3:17 to play in the game. Rochester by 9 at 35-26. Vincent looks to get it in. Gets it into Huffman. Gives it back to Vincent on the right wing behind the arc. Looking down low to see, make that Lefevre. Lefevre gets a triple team to West, now to Vincent. Vincent takes a shot, drives the basket. Her shot, though, no good. And B. Pollock comes out of there with the board. Now to Murph, who gives ahead to Alexa Holland. X brings it up to four, under three to play in the game. Rochester by nine. Murphy holds near the volleyball line. Now Lefevre comes out and applies some pressure. Gives to Riley Holland out top of the key against Bailey Briggs. Riley Holland, couple of dribbles outside to X, and she'll pull it out and set up the offense. 2:35 to play in the game. Rochester by nine. Now to Murphy at the volleyball line. Murphy works left side, cut off by the defense. Now to Holland, top of the key. Riley against Briggs, the man-to-man defense now by the Lady Warriors. Works left side on the baseline, cut off by the help side defense. Now to Murphy high on the left side with 2:20 to play in the game. Rochester up 35-26. Murphy against Lefevre. To X, top of the key. X Holland, left side. And now West fouls X and still going to line to shoot one of the bonus.
West will pick up her third.
.207 to play in the game. Rochester ran off about a minute and a half there.
Yeah, they did a good job of running their stall defense or offense.
Lexa Holland, a freshman. Reed will try to shoot one of the bonus for the Lady Zebras. First on the way is good. Very little rotation. Still have one more. Sorry. I'm hung up on that now. And
right.
I'll probably see that now for the rest of the year. X with one more. Looking to push this to an 11-point lead. Second one's good again. And now Coach Stasiak will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The important message you're about to hear is brought to you by your Culligan man. Is your water hard to live with? Are you tired of water that tastes bad, smells bad, leaves brown stains, and a hard water buildup on your shower walls and faucets? Are you tired of dry skin, dull hair, and dingy laundry? How about replacing appliances prematurely? Well, it's time to do something about it. Your Culligan man has the answer, a water treatment system from Culligan that can eliminate these problems for only $9.95 a month for the first 6 months. Call 574-223-2420 today for details. 574-223-2420 or visit CulliganFultonCounty.com. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2 minutes, 7 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up by 11 at 37-26. Biggest lead of the game right before halftime was 12 in favor of Rochester. Full court press by Rochester. And Bailey Briggs loses the basketball, and then she and Smith tie up. Rochester keep possession on the turnover. Rochester will have it right in front of their own bench. Murphy will look to get it in. 2:04 to play in the game. Rochester by 11. North Miami in a full court for make that a man-to-man press that we haven't seen a whole lot tonight. And Riley Holland, a great job of dribbling right there, keeping it alive so she can get to her feet.
Briggs putting a lot of pressure on the basketball. She did a great job of maintaining control.
Riley Holland against West. Dribbles around the defense, works to the left wing. Now inside the arc, picks up the dribble. Now Murphy, top of the key, it's stolen by Briggs. Briggs against Murphy. We'll go to the basket. Layup is good. 37-28, a minute 35 to play in the game. Rochester by 9. Riley Holland back to X. They're going to have to hurry and get it across the timeline. And now Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. A minute 25 to play in the game. Rochester by 9. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The next time you buy a cart full of groceries, make a car payment, or write that big mortgage check, ask yourself, what would my family do if I wasn't there to buy those groceries, or make that car payment, or write that check? If you didn't like the answer, ask a State Farm agent about life insurance and start getting some answers you will like. Welcome to that place where doing it for them meets doing it today. Get started by contacting State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world, especially now that basketball season has returned. So before heading to the gym or after the big game, even listening on the radio or watching on TV, enjoy the good times with family and friends and Coca-Cola. Grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. When you get together for exciting times, make sure you have plenty of terrific Coca-Cola products on hand, whether it's the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with anything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
A minute 25 to play in the game. Rochester by 9 at 37-25. Rochester has two timeouts. Not sure about North Miami. We'll have to get that number here later. Murphy looks to get it in. Murph gets it into Riley Holland. Riley Holland against West. Now pulls it back outside. Would have been a tough shot.
Yeah.
She'd have went all the way into the basket. Murphy now against the Fever. Really hand-checking her. There's the foul. And now Murph will go to the line to shoot two shots with a minute 15 to play in the game. 9-point lead for Rochester. Murphy with an opportunity to push this back to double digits. Carly Murphy ready. First on the way for Rochester is good as it rattles home. And the lead is back to 10 for Rochester with a minute 15 to play in the game. Post-game stats. Coach's interview coming up after this one. Stay tuned for that. Murph fires a second one. Good again. Lead is 11 for Rochester.
Lady Zebra's not getting the line at all in the third quarter on a perfect 8 for 8 in the fourth.
And on the inbound pass, Keeley Smith forces a turnover as Vincent walks. So Rochester going to get it back underneath their own basket going baseline left. Lob pass into Pollock. B in the lane. Throws up a shot. It's no good, but a foul coming. on North Miami, and Dee Pollock has been pretty quiet this game. Yeah. We'll go to the line to shoot two.
Now, Josie Wood picks up her third, and I think she's a lot of the reason why Pollock has been kind of quiet.
Well, plus that second 2-3 zone.
Yeah.
He is the line for two. Rochester up by 11. First one on the way for the junior is good. So one more.
If you call 13 points quiet.
I do.
For her. Yeah.
40-48. Pollock with one more for Rochester. Second one's no good. And the rebound to Lefevre. 66 seconds to play in the game. Dee Pollock then tips the ball off the hands of Bailey Briggs. It'll go back to Rochester with 64 seconds to play in the game. Nice job by Dee Pollock, who disrupted that pass and tipped it off her fingertips. And then Bailey couldn't save her from going out of bounds. And Rochester's going to get it back. Full-court press by North Miami. Murphy gets it into X, and X and West tie it up. It's going to go to North Miami on the turnover. A minute two to play in the game. Rochester up 40-28. North Miami the basketball baseline left. Vincent looks to get it in. Vincent studies. She's got to do it. Lobs it in over the defense, and Briggs has it. Bailey around the defense, in the paint, kicks into the baseline to Lefevre. Her shot no good. Riley with a good block out and grabs the rebound. And now we're going to have a foul on Vincent. Riley Holland will walk the other end of the floor and shoot two shots.
Vincent will pick up her fourth.
Riley Holland at the line to shoot two with 54.9 to play in the game. Rochester up by 12. Coach Stasiak will go to the bench. He'll send in Lindsey Mitchell with that for the first free throw, which is no good by Holland. C back in for North Miami. Vincent the fifth.
Lady Z's with a 17-5 fourth quarter. Tied at the end of three.
Yeah, you're right. 17-5. Good call.
Block out.
Second one is good by Holland. Biggest lead of the afternoon. Then Alexa Holland steals the inbound pass. 41-28 Rochester. And C commits the foul, and X will go back to the line to shoot two. Bailey Abbott will come in for Rochester as Coach Stasiak empties the bench. They lead by 13. Becky Malco and Keith Stasiak will come back in at 12.
Block out.
X ready. First one, good. 42-28 Rochester. And like Brad said, now Rochester on a 19-5 run here in this quarter. So V. Pollock comes out. She had a solid day. Riley Holland comes out. She had a good day running the point. And X with one more free throw for Rochester. X has had a good day.
Yes, she has.
Second one for the freshman is good again. 43-28.
She's got six in this quarter, 11 for the game for her.
45 seconds to play in the game. D bounce pass is tipped out of bounds by Alexa Holland.
Lady D's 12 of 14 from the free throw line in the fourth quarter.
Fever looks to get it in with 42 seconds to play in the game. Down to 39. Josie Wood around the defense. She'll go to the basket. There's a shot. It's good. Not with Ingram from that shot. Got it to go. 43-30. A 20-7 run. Bailey Abbott, left hand layup is good. Nice look by Alexa Holland. Rochester up 45-30 with 20 seconds to play in the game. Josie Wood, three on the way, top of the key. Yep. 45-33.
Gives her 12.
Right through the defense goes Becky Malco with 7, and that's going to do it. Rochester going to grab their first conference win of the year, and even their mark at 5-5 by the final of 45-33 win here at North Miami High School. When we come back, post-game thoughts after this on 92.1 WROI.